there are many different types of grounding systems, but in general, the larger and more complex is the grounded object, the same can usually be said for its grounding. Though, size isn't everything. Other variables dictating the complexity and extent of grounding systems are soil type, presence of other grounding system, and electrical conduits in the ground. In this instance, however, there is no need for voltage or current probes, as both the green and black leads are connected to a reference object, the railroad tracks, using a G-clamp. Bridges are a good example, and what better way to analyze the quality of grounding of a one that is yet to be finished than with the use of the four-pole impedance measurement method. The red and blue leads are, on the other hand, firmly connected to an exposed grounding strip. The connection to the bridge is self-explanatory, while the connection to the railroad tracks is based on the valid assumption that the resistance of the entire system, at least locally, is very close to 0 ohms and can be excluded in the end measurement result. The tester then basically acts as an ohm meter with the ground and installed grounding system completing the loop. And to some extent, by using an intuitive tester like the MI3288 earth insulation tester that has built-in help menus and variable frequency voltage generator for eliminating electromagnetic interference in high noise environments. The result should be under 10 ohms. Anything over could be problematic. That's all for now. Keep testing and stay safe. We invite you to like, subscribe, and share our videos.